In this video, we will set up CardFlows. So I just installed the plugin and I will start the wizard. So it's like the onboarding process. Welcome to CardFlows. We'll have to choose the page builder. I really recommend to use Gutenberg because it's included in WordPress. It's really powerful and it's not bloated. But if you prefer Elementor or another page builder, you can choose it. Next, I already have WooCommerce installed, but they also want to install the cart abandonment plugin, so I will say yes. And now the plugin is ready. I just can create a flow. If you click on add new, you will have the flow templates already made, and you can also sync the library. There was a small problem. The flow templates wasn't loading, and I fixed the problem. It was in settings. The ready templates was for Elementor, but just before in the onboarding process, I chose the Gutenberg, so I changed again and put Gutenberg, and then it's working. So just go on the settings, check if it's correct, and it will fix the problem if you have the same problem. So actually, as you can see, it's the flow templates for Gutenberg only. For Elementor, there is a bit more templates, I guess. So this is the flow templates for Gutenberg. You can view all the steps, you can view the demo without importing it. You can also preview. Let's try to find another one. So let's say I want to sell an ebook, or at least give for free an ebook or something like this. So the landing page, the checkout page, everything is okay for me. So I will import flow. So this is all the steps in the flow. It starts with the landing page, go on the checkout page. After, you have the ebook upsell, ebook downsell, and the thank you page when the order is done. You can see the settings, flow title, sandbox, analytics. You can see the analytics, the order value, the all the steps like the unique visits, the conversion rate, all the stats. And then we'll go quickly in the settings so you can disallow search engine for indexing flows, the funnels steps, so I don't want the global checkout. So it was the checkout page I imported from the template. If you want your website, your e-commerce website, for example, to have a global checkout page, you can create it and set up here. And you can also enable PayPal reference. It's for the one click upsell or one click downsell. You have to enable it, but you also have to call PayPal to enable it on your PayPal account. Offer settings. So for upsell or downsell offers, it will create another order and it will not be added in the main order if you create a new child. So it's recommended to create a new child order. For permalinks, you can set default permalinks in the settings permalinks, or you can just use these steps. I recommend to don't put card flows flow with the flow name and step name. I recommend to use default WordPress permalink. And you can enable Facebook pixel. You can also track the whole website. You just have to put your pixel ID and it will fetch the events, initiate checkout, add payment info. So you'll be able to retarget and stuff like this. And you can do the same with Google Analytics. It's really nice. So for settings is done, it's really easy and fast. So we'll see how to edit a flow. So this is all the steps. Again, go and edit. Then it's Gutenberg, so you can directly edit with Gutenberg. And that's it. So this is the title and this is Gutenberg page builder. So if you want to add a block, you can do so. You can change the picture, you can change the button. For example, it's the next step button. So you can attempt block recovery to get the thing. That is just like colon, image, text. It's really easy. Once it's done, you click on update and you can try the step actually. So I want the ebook. It goes on the second page, checkout page, but then we didn't create the product, so there is nothing. So now the flow is ready. I imported it, and to have a try, it needs a WooCommerce product. So I will add new product. So test product like 10, and that's it. Okay, so the product is ready. So I'll go in the flow, I'll go on test, and in settings, I will set up sandbox mode. So it will randomly pick a product. So now I go back on the steps and we will see how the funnel is working. So this is the landing page. The customer goes on this page, click on the CTA, get the ebook. Okay, so there is the buying info with the product. Test product. Okay. You have also the downsell. Yes, I want this. And when you click on yes, it will add the downsell product in the order. But I guess it's not working because there is not actually the product paperback copy. So it's not adding it. And you can fill the info. Okay. So the billing details are ready. The test product is done. I don't want the downsell. So I place the order. So let's say the customer pay the order with the proper gateway, so PayPal, Stripe, as you want. And then it will be on this page, ebook upsell, so you can have the special offer, 100% off, add to my order. Of course, the order exists, so it will add it. And then the ebook downsell offer, before you go, you can also add this one. And at the end, they will see the thank you page, so you can explain and you can show the order details. That's it. So this is the funnel, and you can add new step, you can edit, you can remove a step. And if you want to add a new step, you can pick a landing page, checkout page, upsell, downsell, thank you page, opt-in page. So that's it. You get the overview of the page. You can go on the flow if you want to see the analytics. Actually, it's not live, so you don't see anything. And for example, the landing page will edit it. We'll just show you about the checkout page, how to add a product. So go on edit. Then you have the design of the checkout page, you have the products, so you can add a new product and you pick the product you already made, for example the test product or the ebook product as you want. You can add a coupon if you want, so, and you can add product options, so you save. Then you can create an order bump, and as I told you before, you have to set a product, you have to create it. You can add a discount if you want, and this is the settings of the order bump about the text. You can even replace the first product. You can also set if it adds the ordered bump, then you can define the next step. For enable checkout offer, just before the customer add the product in the checkout and will check out, you can show something to like show a product to add it to his order. And then you can define also the checkout form. I recommend to collapse the coupon field, and you can even remove the additional field. And for the settings, you can change the place order button text, you can enable the cart editing on checkout, and you can add some custom script. So it's really easy. You can also edit the checkout page with Gutenberg. Okay, so you click on attempt block recovery, and then you have the checkout form. So as you see, there is another cart flow block. If you go there, checkout form, but it's already added. And then you can change everything. You can choose a two-step form, it's like this. You can change the color, you can change the heading color, you can change the input field. About the two-step, you can change the get your free copy, you can choose the step one, you can choose the step two, you can change the success and error message, you can change the product option, the order bump, you can change the skin. You can also, if it's enabled, you can change the pre-checkout offer design. That's it. So it's more about design, and you can add some content. And the last step we have to see is the cart abandonment. So it's not really something linked with cart flows, but it's made by cart flow. So you just have the recoverable orders. You can set up a follow-up emails. So you can, for example, active template 30 minutes after the cart is abandoned. You can just send this, so the customer will receive this email and he can continue to purchase his cart. You can also try by sending a test email. And you have the settings. You can disable the tracking. You can exclude email for the different processing order. You can delete the coupons automatically created. You can enable GDPR integration and the webhook. That's it. If you go on the homepage, you will see everything about the statistics and the revenue you made. So I recommend you to use cart flows if you need a funnel builder plugin for WordPress. If you already have, for example, an email software like CRM or something like this. But if you don't have WordPress website, and if you don't have also email solution, email system or whatever, I recommend you to use system.io or maybe Kartra or like ClickFunnels, but it's really expensive. It's better to go on system.io. And if you just need a funnel builder, you can use Leadpage, or you can use also system.io again. So if you have any question, you can just ask in the comments below. If you like the video, just add a like, please, and follow us.